Ella's Beef Easters, Radio Air Check, and Classic TV Channel.
This is CBS News in Washington, George Herman reporting. New York's Governor Nelson Rockefeller, under heavy pressure from moderate Republicans to get into the presidential arena, is holding a strategy session at his New York apartment, and CBS News correspondent Morton Dean reports.
At 812 Fifth Avenue in Midtown Manhattan, a group of named Republicans from around the country, 32 in all, are meeting at the behest of Governor Rockefeller. It is believed that on the basis of what he hears today, Rockefeller will be that much closer to a decision on whether to actively campaign for the presidency. But he said he won't announce that decision today. One surprise guest at the Rockefeller apartment is the 1964 GOP vice presidential candidate, William Miller. Miller, a conservative, told newsmen that Rockefeller has his wholehearted support. Miller splitting with the man who headed the 64 ticket, Barry Goldwater, who has endorsed Richard Nixon. Emphasizing the possibility that Rockefeller may enter the Oregon primary as an active candidate was the appearance of Robert Price, a brokerage house executive who headed up the one major primary campaign that Rockefeller won in 1964, and that was Oregon. Morton Dean, CBS News, New York.
On the CBS News broadcast, Face the Nation, Governor Romney of Michigan said today that Rockefeller should enter the race quickly by declaring himself in the Oregon primary election of May 28th. Governor Romney said he still hasn't closed the door on the idea of working for Richard Nixon himself. Florida's teachers' strike, apparently all settled last Friday, has developed a new hitch. The Florida Education Association has asked the state's teachers not to go back to work Monday as planned until all the county school boards in Florida agree to accept all the striking teachers back on the job without any reprisals. The association reports that school boards in several of the counties are showing openly hostile attitudes toward the teachers. In Pittsburgh, striking teachers voted to end their 11-day walkout after a county judge agreed to conduct a collective bargaining election. In Delano, California, farm labor organizer Cesar Chavez ended his 25-day fast in a Roman Catholic mass celebrated in the city's community park. Among the participants, Senator Robert Kennedy, who flew in by a special chartered plane, explaining that he wanted to show respect for what he called one of the heroic figures of our time, Cesar Chavez. Senator Kennedy, by the way, also appeared to Britons on a BBC interview today and severely criticized the Johnson administration's conduct of the war in Vietnam, but he said that although he had seriously considered entering the presidential race this year, he had decided against it. In Vietnam, American headquarters has declined comment on Washington reports that General Westmoreland wants 206,000 additional American troops. All such information is highly classified, said the American officers. General Westmoreland helped activate a new American command in the two northernmost provinces today to improve the setup for the expected test of strength just south of the demilitarized zone. And the enemy subsequently launched another of those destructive probing attacks, destroying tons of American supplies and ammunition with artillery and rockets. More news in half a minute.
True or false? Children are more susceptible to meningitis than adults. This is Charles Kuralt. Tomorrow on Dimension on Health, I'll answer that question in a quiz on meningitis. Also on Dimension tomorrow, Mike Wallace talks with Elliot Janeway, author of Economics of Crisis. Mr. Janeway discusses his views on how the Vietnam War is affecting our economy at home. Be listening for Dimension on Health and Personal Close-Up tomorrow on this CBS Radio Network station, where what you want to know comes first.
Czechoslovakia's President Antonin Novotny, one of the last of the Stalinist leaders of the Soviet satellite countries, is reported today leaving Prague for an extended stay at a health resort. Some think it the first step towards resigning for reasons of health. Novotny has been under heavy pressure to quit and has been deprived of much of his power. And today, more than 3,000 Czechs marched to the grave of the late Czech foreign minister and democratic hero, Jan Masaryk, who has been a communist unperson for 20 years since his death. Czechoslovakia's new party leader has allowed the rehabilitation of Masaryk and his father, Tomáš Masaryk, who created the Czech Republic. A new era of freedom in Czechoslovakia and signs that Poland and other satellites want some for themselves. That's the latest. This is George Herman in Washington.
What happens in the world during the night? Find out weekday mornings with Dallas Townsend on the World News Roundup over the CBS Radio network station.
WFPG Steel Pier in Atlantic City, 5 minutes past 5 o'clock.